The Space Shuttle, whose official designation was the Space Transportation System, STS, was launched on 135 missions into space between 1981 and 2011. It was the only reusable transporter to begin regular flight operations, unlike its Russian counterpart, Buran, which completed only one unmanned test flight. Without the Space Shuttle, the construction of the ISS and several manned servicing missions to the Hubble Space Telescope would not have been possible. While the Space Shuttle failed to live up to the expectations of a space cab, it's still a milestone in space travel, albeit a very expensive one, as the total cost is at least $208 billion. The history of the Space Shuttle began on January the 3rd, 1972, when US President Richard Nixon initiated a program to develop reusable spacecraft, which was controversial, as there were notable voices within NASA who would have preferred a manned flight to Mars rather than a long-term commitment to low Earth orbit. The Space Shuttle system consisted of three components: an orbiter, an orange external auxiliary tank, and two external solid rocket boosters were attached to the side of the tank. Although not all parts of this system were reusable because of the external auxiliary tank burned in the Earth's atmosphere, while the solid rockets fell into the water on parachutes and were recovered by special ships, and the orbiter, as a glider, came back to Earth. The first space shuttle, built for testing purposes because it never went into space, was the Enterprise. It was named after the famous spaceship from Star Trek. At first, however, the name Constitution was intended, but thousands of letters from science fiction fans changed the minds of those responsible. The first flight of the Space Shuttle STS-1 into space was on April 12, 1981, when Columbia launched from Cape Canaveral. The first mission was to check that all systems were working as planned. It returned after 2 days, 6 hours, 20 minutes, and 53 seconds. Besides Columbia, there was also the Space Shuttles Atlantis, Discovery, Challenger, and Endeavour, the latter being built after the Challenger accident. Before the Space Shuttle could be launched from the Kennedy Space Center in Cape Canaveral, the individual components had to be assembled. First, the solid rocket boosters, SBRs, were assembled and then were attached to the external fuel tank. Then the orbiter was assembled and the Space Shuttle rolled leisurely from the vehicle assembly building by crawler to the launch pad. Final tests were then performed at the launch pad and the countdown began 3 days before the launch date. At launch, 6 seconds before liftoff, the main engines were ignited, and when the countdown reached zero, the solid boosters were activated. Now there was no turning back, and the Space Shuttle took off. At first, it was rather leisurely because the shuttle weighed 2.03 million kilograms at launch, and it took 20 seconds for the boosters and engines to accelerate the shuttle to 139 meters per second. After 1 minute, the shuttle had reached a speed of 433 meters per second and had used almost 500,000 pounds of fuel. Then, after 2 minutes, the shuttle had reached an altitude of 45 kilometers and a speed of 1,279 meters per second. Since the solid fuel boosters, which had provided 5.6 million pounds of thrust up to this point, had burned out, they were now jettisoned and glided back to Earth on parachutes. From this point on, the shuttle was accelerated only by its three Rocketdyne RS-25 engines, which were a feat of engineering, producing 1.2 million pounds of thrust and using a gimbal suspension to direct the thrust jet. 8 minutes and 30 seconds after launch, the Space Shuttle separated from its external auxiliary fuel tank, which was filled with over 500,000 liters of liquid oxygen and 1.5 million liters liquid hydrogen, now depleted. The shuttle was now flying at a speed of 8 kilometers per second, and without fuel tank, the main engines were just dead weight. The final push it needed to enter orbit was provided by the two smaller orbital maneuvering system, OMS, engines. Once in orbit, the shuttle swung into an elliptical orbit around the planet, circling the Earth every 90 minutes. Due to the centrifugal force counteracting the gravitational force, the shuttle was in a stable orbit. Now only the maneuvering thrusters were needed. The payload bay door would open so the radiator panels could release excess heat and the actual mission of the shuttle could begin. Curiously, the Space Shuttle flew upside down most of the time, i.e. topside toward Earth as well as tail first, to protect the crew from the dangers of space debris, among other things. The mission profile of the Space Shuttle included the transport of astronauts, satellites, modules for the International Space Station, as well as space telescopes, which had to be brought into a low orbit between 330 to 550 kilometers height. A few missions also had a military character, which is still subject to secrecy. Furthermore, it could be used as a mobile research laboratory if the space lab or space hab was in the cargo bay. Usually a mission lasted 1 to 2 weeks. The landing of the Space Shuttle was complicated because it did not use its main engines on the return flight to Earth, but relied on its reaction control system, RCS, with its 44 small liquid-fueled rocket thrusters. The forward rockets of the reaction control system, located near the nose of the Space Shuttle orbiter, included 14 primary and 2 vernier RCS rockets. The rest of the rocket thrusters were located in the 2 OMS pods at the rear of the orbiter. To enter the atmosphere, it needed only a short ignition of the OMS. After surviving the fiery 1260 degrees Celsius entry thanks to its heat shield, consisting of 24,300 silica tiles, and had already lost a large part of its speed, it flew a few curves to lose further speed, because in orbit, it has a speed of about 28,000 kilometers per hour, and now had to get below the speed of sound. Once it had lost enough speed, it began its approach to land. It usually landed at Cape Canaveral, but sometimes it had to divert to another runway because of factors such as the weather was not cooperating. Then it landed at either Edwards Air Force Base, California, or at White Sands, New Mexico. If it did not land at Cape Canaveral, it then had to be brought back to the Kennedy Space Center, KSC, by a converted Boeing. Nowadays, the shuttles are in various museums in the US, and the Endeavour can be seen at the California Science Center in Los Angeles. The darkest hours. During the shuttle program, 2 serious disasters occurred in which 14 astronauts lost their lives. First, on January the 28th, 1986, the Challenger exploded 73 seconds after launch due to defective sealing rings on one of the 2 solid rocket boosters. This accident was favored by unusually cold temperatures in Florida. And on February the 1st, 2003, the Space Shuttle Columbia broke apart on re-entry into Earth's atmosphere during its landing approach. The cause was a damaged heat shield, as parts of the frozen foam insulation of the tank had already separated during launch and damaged the heat shield on the left wing. Thank you for your attention. If you like this video, please leave us a like or write us a comment.